So now we are going to talk about different kinds of prior art databases. So what kind of prior art databases we know? So most of the university researchers and PhD students and professor, they do research, they publish paper, they get some insightful data, they get some very good statistical analysis, and then they arrive to a conclusion and they conclude the research topic. During this entire process, what I have observed, I have seen that most of the university researchers, they do research and they do search about the topic, about the prior art topic from non-patent databases, which is basically the technical journals like IEEE Explore, ACM Computing Survey, Science Direct, Nature, etc., etc. Because these journals basically discloses the topic they are doing research, and but very less number of people in academia are currently doing their research based on the patent databases. So patent database is basically it is a database of a particular country which has all of the patent published, all of the application filed till date, and it is a very rich database because it includes variety of technology and scientific topics related to variety of things. So here we are going to talk about prior art database, what kind of prior art databases available. So firstly, we are going to talk about patent databases. So when we talk about patent databases, more than 250 countries have signed the Vienna Convention. Now, what does it mean? It means that more than 200 and 250 countries have the patent office, has the mechanism to file the patent for an invention. And all of these countries maintain a regional database of patent for their country. So here you can see some of the prominent patent databases I have mentioned, like eSpaceNet Patent Search, which is a European body for all of the patent filed in Europe. Then we have United States Patent and Trademark Office, which basically is a government body for United States patent filing. Then we have a worldwide organization, WIPO, which is World Intellectual Property Organization. Then we have, regional country databases. Apart from that, we have some private databases also, which is basically paid. So one of the example you can see here is the Derwent Innovation and Orbit Intelligence. These are the paid databases which basically provides the aggregation of the regional databases of the countries, and they provide an interface where you can search the patent from all over the world. Then we have a free database like Google Patents, where you know anybody can access that information freely. And then we have we also have a regional database of our India, which is Office of Controller General of Patents and Design and Trademark. So you can also search the Indian patent and application which has been filed. So these are the example of patent databases. Again, these are not the comprehensive databases which we have provided, but these are the prominent databases, regional databases and paid databases which you are seeing right now. Then we have a non-patent database for a prior art search. And considering most of you people are already university researchers, most of you people are already PhD students, so you are already aware about scholarly sources for searching the non-patent literature or the scientific articles like IEEE Explore, Science Direct, ACM, Nature, Google Scholar, or a search engine like Microsoft Bing or Google. So based on what we have saw, we can divide the entire prior art databases in two parts. One is public databases, another is private databases. Public databases are those which belongs to a particular country. These are the regional databases, and these are freely available to all of us. So, for example, United States Patent and Trademark Office, European Body eSpaceNet, the Worldwide Organization WIPO Patent Scope, Indian patent databases, which is known as INPAS. Then we have some other private body, private organization who provide the free public databases like lens.org and the Google patent. So these are the example of public databases. Then we have private databases also. These databases are very extensive, and they provide useful utility to search efficiently in the patent databases. So Derwent Innovation, Questol Orbit, LexisNexis, Drug Patent Watch, Patbase, PatSnap, these are some of the private companies, or we can say that private entities who provides the paid databases related to prior art search. So going forward, we will see one by one, like what type of regional patent databases these are, and what type of search utility these databases provide, how we can search our topic, and how we can do the effective research in academia. So here you can see that this is the snapshot of USPTO patent search tool. So USPTO is basically United States Patent and Trademark Office, and it provides a free public database where you can search all of the US patent application and granted patent. So let's see how it works. So you can see that this is a United States Patent and Trademark Office. This is their official site, and they provide the search tool. So here we have quick search, advanced and patent number search. We'll quickly see what this is. So here you can see that in quick search, when I clicked, I got an interface where I can search any topic. So here you can see that we can put our query here. We can put certain Boolean operators here, and we can search the data. And this data is very exhaustive, and it has data from 1976 to till date. So suppose you are doing a research on a particular topic, like image processing technique in a camera. So let's search a camera. Here, you can search this term in all of the fields related to the patent document. For example, you can search that topic in the title, in the abstract. In variety of fields. So let's say all fields. So you can see that we put two topics here, the camera and the image processing. Now we will get all of the patents related to camera and image processing, because it is taking time. The search query is very broad. It is taking time. Let's restrict our search. So let's search camera in only title and image processing in only title. So this is going to search the topic, the camera in the title and the image processing in the title. So all of the patents which has been filed, in where the title discloses the keyword camera and image processing, will be displayed here. Similarly, this USPTO search tool also provides an advanced search technique where you can do more advanced search, where you can build a complex query. So here you can see the example of query. So let's see, and they have provided all the fields, all the lesions related to this complex query. Suppose we have to search camera and image processing related patent in the year. So here we can see how to put the date restriction. So APD, if you want to see all of the application file in 2020. So there was a certain error in our query. So we have to check if something is missing. Let's check this again. Let's make it a less complex query. So basically, this will give us all of the results related to these terms.